Rubik's Cube, which, as you know, is there's 43 quintillion ways you can mix this cube up. I'm not going to do 43 quintillion moves because we haven't got time. But what I will do is I'll give it, say, let's try and get it about, let's try and get it about 20 moves away from being solved. Okay, so we'll start like that. So that's pretty much, that's pretty well mixed. So I just want you to imagine, even though we're about 20 moves away from it being solved, just want you to imagine what it would look like if it was maybe 15 moves away. You'd start to see some patterns emerge on the cube, and then perhaps 4 moves away, 2 moves away, until we were just 1 move away, and then the cube would be solved. So that's one thing we can do with the Rubik's Cube. There's another thing we can do as well, which is to give the cube another mix. Now if we take that cube, which as you can see is pretty well mixed up, we take this bag. I'm just going to place the cube in the bag and put it right to the bottom like that, and we just click our fingers. When you reach inside, you'll see, maybe I'll just twist it, the cube is solved and we've got a completely empty bag, as you can see. I'll just check that for you so you know that it's that is definitely empty. You don't look convinced, guys. I'll tell you what, just to be sure, just make